I'm Tianjing. Many of us have been following the CDC recommendations that everyone try to wear masks, maintain distance from others, and wash hands. These things are effective, simple to remember, and are continuously mentioned. I noticed that there is one thing that should be done that is just as important as those strategies, yet it's not a CDC recommendation, and is rarely highlighted by other sources, and that is minimizing the time of exposure. Let me explain. SARS-CoV-2 can spread through the air. When someone with the virus coughs, sneezes, talks, or just even breathes, they expel droplets that contain varying amounts of the virus. Some of the droplets are heavy and fall to the ground from gravity, and others are small and light, which are called aerosols, and are able to float through the air. The aerosols float around and have no place to go in closed spaces, putting everyone in that space at risk. There's actually a certain amount of viral particles that must get into your body for you to get sick. This amount is called an infectious dose. In a case study described in the journal Emerging Infectious Diseases, there was an outbreak of COVID-19 on January 24, 2020 that started from a restaurant in China. An asymptomatic carrier sat here. They breathed continuously, which kept adding viral particles to the closed room. On one side of the wall, there was an air conditioner circulating the virus in this part of the restaurant. Three families spent up to at least 53 minutes in the restaurant while the carrier was present. These people ended up contracting COVID-19 because they inhaled an infectious dose. Note, this happened when some were even sitting much more than 6 feet away from the carrier. This is similar to being exposed to ionizing radiation over time, where there is a certain total amount that is dangerous to humans. People who are at risk try to minimize the amount of time they are exposed to radiation, and use dosimeters that measure a total exposure amount. Some dosimeters sound an alarm when they reach a certain amount. In a way, your body acts as its own viral dosimeter, as when your body obtains the infectious dose, your body may sound the alarm by coming down with COVID-19. The longer you stay in a closed, unventilated space, the greater your risk of coming down with COVID-19 because of the increased amount of time of possibly being exposed to the virus. The people in the restaurant that sat more than 6 feet away still came down with COVID-19 because they filled the viral dosimeters by staying in a virus-filled area for the duration of a dinner. Healthcare workers and essential workers are more at risk because they spend more time being exposed to the virus, and so are more likely to get the infectious dose of SARS-CoV-2. What we can learn from this is in addition to following the CDC recommendations, we should minimize the amount of exposure time to the virus. If you can't control the amount of time you're in a space, you can try to limit the amount of virus around you. You can do this by ventilation, such as opening a window in a closed space, and even more so by attaching a fan to the open window to blow air out. By doing this, it can lower the amount of virus in the area. Another way is to add a hospital-grade filter to the room. This can remove the vast majority of particles from the air, therefore lowering the risk of reaching the infectious dose and getting COVID-19. If you spend less time in closed spaces, get fresh air into the room, or clean the air with a filter, you're minimizing filling your viral dosimeter and decreasing the chance of getting sick.